Hello everyone, my name is Danish and for the next few minutes I will be discussing the future of India's trade policy and the impact of reforms undertaken. When the Narendra Modi government unveiled its first trade policy in 2015, targets set were the doubling of exports from India to $900 billion by the year 2020. They had also laid down the introduction of new schemes such as the Merchandise Exports from India Scheme and Services Exports from India Scheme to boost outward shipments. The stated aim of the government was to increase India's exports of merchandise and services from $465 billion in 2013-14 to approximately $900 billion by 2019-20. It was also stated to raise India's share of world exports from the current 2% to 3.5% by the stipulated deadline. But before we go into the specifics, let's look at India's current prospects in the changing global landscape. It is by now clear that the world is looking at India to provide fresh impetus to the global economy, with the rate of growth of the country and its increasing share in the global trade market. Experts worldwide expect a similar scenario to occur in India as to what happened in the mid-2000s, when China's booming economy had worldwide effects and influenced the growth of the world economy. But it's also clear that we have some catching up to do before matching China's progression. One of the primary drivers of growth and the highest potential industry in India is the manufacturing sector. Manufacturing should be having a bigger influence on India's GDP than what it has currently, although the government has increased the sector through schemes such as the Make in India initiative. It is imperative that in a scenario where almost 1 million workers enter the labor force every month in our country, a labor intensive industry like manufacturing should be given any boost possible for it to grow. There are a couple of points that could be critical in driving India's trade policy in the future. Firstly, it is important for India to integrate itself more deeply into the global trade and supply chain of goods, either through specific partnerships with countries or through regional trade agreements. India should focus on creating long-term and beneficial trading partnerships with countries like the US, who remain one of the biggest consumer markets in the world and are a country that has been recognizing India's place in the world recently through agreements in other sectors such as defense and education. Joining regional agreements with the rest of South Asia, the Middle East and Southeast Asia remain attractive options. Of late, the other countries who link agreements with India seem to be gaining more out of the partnership than India does. Experts cite the lack of competitiveness in the manufacturing sector and the lack of innovation and investment in sectors such as textiles and garments to be one of the reasons. The next point we focused on would be the adaptation of India to the global trade trends and standards. Regional trade agreements would play a big role in this, as it would force India to adjust to the standards and requirements, thereby proving beneficial in the long run. There is also a question of adapting to the growth of Indian trade, one such example being the declaration of the World Trade Organization, making India ineligible for export incentives that only poorer countries are allowed, citing that India's per capita gross national product, or the GNP, exceeded $1,000 for 3 years in a row from 2012 to 15. So it is up to the government to build policies around the changing status and replace the old schemes with new ones that would take Indian trade to the next step. The proposed setting up of a host of institutions, including the Trade Council and the National Committee on Trade Facilitation, to improve India's share in global trade and to implement WTO obligations would ease this transition to some level. Finally, one of the key markers on India's trade policy would be the response on India's adaptation to the policies set by the World Trade Organization and the working out of multilateral trade systems or agreements with partner countries. Also, a lot rests on the development of the Make in India initiative and its adaptation to newer technologies, which could prove critical in the growth of India's manufacturing sector as of now. It is important to ensure that red tapeism and protectionist policies do not affect the initiative. As India looks to carve out its position in the world and emerge as a force to be reckoned with, the importance of trade policies and reforms that drive the growth of the economy cannot be stated enough. Thank you.